थैंक यू जीसस, परमेश्वर की धन्यवाद आज सुबह के समय फिर एक बार परमेश्वर के संगति में एक बार मिल के आने के लिए। परमेश्वर एक अच्छा अवसर खोला, इसलिए मैं परमेश्वर को धन्यवाद देता हूँ। आई रियली थैंक द लॉर्ड फॉर दिस वंडरफुल टाइम। पिछले दिनों में हम लोग परमेश्वर के वचनों से कलीसिया के बारे में हम लोग सीधा फ्रॉम लास्ट प्रीवियस डेज वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट द चर्च। तो कलीसिया के बारे में हम लोग सीख रहे थे। कलीसिया को एक खेत के समान नहीं तो एक फार्म के समान उदाहरण की बताया गया है। द चर्च इज बीन गिवेन इन ए फेज ऑफ एग्जाम्पल रिप्रेजेंटिंग ए फार्म और ए प्लांटेशन इन विच वी वर स्पीकिंग अबाउट द चर्च। जैसे कि हम लोग कलीसिया के बारे में याद कर रहे थे। सो कलीसिया को कलीसिया की जो उदाहरण बताया गया है जैसे कि खेत नहीं तो फार्म के बारे में उदाहरण दिया गया है, इसलिए एक चीज़ है खेत लगाने की एक ही मकसद होता है ताकि उसके अंदर फल पूर्णता हो, नहीं तो उसमें कुछ फल मिल सके, इसीलिए ही खेत का क्या होता है खेत लगाने के कारण, नहीं तो खेत में पेड़ पौधे लगाने के कारण यह है कि खेती जो कर रहा है वो व्यक्ति उसमें से कुछ लाभ नहीं तो फायदा जमाने की कोशिश कर रहा है, नहीं तो फायदा पाने की इच्छा के हिसाब से ही वो खेती करता है। वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड ए पर्सन ट्राइज टू यूज प्लांटेशंस और ही प्लांट्स ट्रीज टू गेन फ्रूट्स। सो चर्च शुड हैव फ्रूट्स। सो यस्टरडे वी वर डिस्कसिंग रिगार्डिंग जोसेफ हु वाज ए फ्रूटफुल वाइन। यूसुफ के बारे में हम लोग देख रहे थे, यूसुफ कैसा है फल पूर्ण एक व्यक्ति के समान हम लोग देख सकते हैं। इस लाइफ वाज कम्प्लीटली रिवीलिंग फ्रूट्स। उसके जीवन इतना पूर्णता में था कि वो क्या कर रहा था, फल पूर्णता को दिखाने वाले अनुभव हम लोग देख सकते हैं। इवन द चर्च शुड बी फ्रूटफुल। कलीसिया भी क्या करना चाहिए, फल पूर्णता से भरी पड़ी रहना चाहिए। द चर्च शुड रिवील द फ्रूट्स टू द आउटर कम्युनिटी, टू द लैंड और टू द नेबरिंग पीपल। नहीं तो कलीसिया क्या करना चाहिए, फल पूर्णता को क्या करना चाहिए, बाहरी दुनिया को क्या करना चाहिए, देने की एक हिस्सा जरूरतमंद चीज़ों से कलीसिया के अंदर दिखाई देना चाहिए। इफ़ चर्च इज़ बीन एग्जाम्पल्ड एज ए फार्म और ए प्लांटेशन इट शुड बियर द बेस्ट फ्रूट। अगर कलीसिया को एक उदाहरण के तरीके से एक फार्म नहीं तो प्लांटेशन नहीं तो खेत के बारे में अगर बताया गया है तो नियुक्त रीति से अच्छे फलों से फल पूर्णता क्या करना चाहिए, दिखाई देनी चाहिए। जोसेफ वास सो वी शुड बी। जैसे यूसुफ था वैसे हमें भी बनना जरूरी है। वी शुड बी फ्रूटफुल इन ऑल द एरियाज ऑफ आवर लाइफ। हमारे जीवन में हर स्थितियों में हम लोग को क्या करना चाहिए, फल पूर्णता हमारे जीवन में बहुत जरूरत वाली एक हिस्सा है। आज हम लोग देखेंगे कि फल पूर्णता की परिस्थिति किस तरीके से, तीन रीति से बाइबल में बताया गया है। द फ्रूट्स आर बीन differentiated into three categories. The first one which I discussed was a fruitful tree. पहली वाली हिस्सा जो फल पूर्णता के बारे में मैंने बोला था कि जो फल पूर्णता। The next thing we need to identify fruitlessness, not bearing any fruit. Let's turn our Bibles to Luke chapter 13 verse 6. Luke का लिखित सुसमाचार 13वां अध्याय उसकी 6वां वचन। In this particular verse, Jesus स्पीकिंग थ्रू ए पैराबल। यीशु मसीह एक दृष्टांत के द्वारा बताने वाले एक अनुभव देख सकते हैं। वी सी इट लाइक दिस। देन ही बिगैन टेलिंग दिस पैराबल। ए सर्टेन मैन हैड ए फिग ट्री दैट हैड बीन प्लांटेड इन हिज वाइनयार्ड एंड ही केम लुकिंग फॉर फ्रूट ऑन इट बट ही डिड नॉट फाइंड एनी। यहाँ पे हम लोग देख सकते हैं एक व्यक्ति क्या कर रहा, अपने खेत में नहीं तो अपने प्लांटेशन में, अपने उपजाऊ जमीन में उसने क्या किया, एक पेड़ लगाया और उसने क्या किया, आशा के साथ पेड़ के निकट आया। ए सर्टेन मैन हैड ए फिग ट्री इन हिज वाइनयार्ड। ही केम लुकिंग आफ्टर फ्रूट। व्हाई डिड ही प्लांट दैट फिग ट्री? क्यों उसने उस पेड़ को लगाया, ताकि ही एक्सपेक्टेड सम फ्रूट। बिना फल के कोई भी किसी पेड़ को नहीं लगता। नोबडी प्लांट्स ए ट्री। कोई ऐसा कोई व्यक्ति है ही नहीं जो पेड़ लगा था और फल नहीं पाए, ऐसा सोचने वाला कोई नहीं होता। नोबडी लाइक्स टू प्लांट ए ट्री एंड डज नॉट एक्सपेक्ट फॉर ए फ्रूट. सो द एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ ए ट्री और एल्स द एक्सपेक्टेशन ऑफ ए प्लांटर इज फ्रूट. विदाउट फ्रूट द प्लांटेड द प्लांटर डज नॉट लेबर. इसलिए हमें मालूम करना चाहिए कभी भी एक खेती करने वाला व्यक्ति बिना फल का फल नहीं लगाएगा, नहीं तो बीज नहीं बोएगा. हेलो, वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्लांटर द प्लांटर नहीं तो द फार्मर ही इज द पर्सन हु ऑलवेज सीक्स. हेलो, जो कोई खेत में पेड़ लगाया है वो हरदम क्या करता है, ढूंढते आता है. ही हैज ए टेंडेंसी टू सीक टू फाइंड समथिंग फ्रॉम हिज प्लांटेशन. नहीं तो उसकी खेत के अंदर से कुछ ना कुछ उगते हिस्सा देखना चाहता है. इट्स अ डिमांड, इट्स अ रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ द प्लांटर. नहीं तो एक पेड़ लगाने वाले की जरूरतमंद वाली हिस्सा है कि वो क्या करता है, कुछ पाने की आशा कर रहा है. हेलो, वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड इफ वी आर प्लांटेड इन द चर्च, कलीसिया के अंदर परमेश्वर हमें उगवाए हैं. इफ वी आर प्लांटेड इन ए फार्म, अगर खेत कलीसिया बोलकर जो खेत में परमेश्वर हमें उगवाए हैं, ही इज एक्सपेक्टिंग ए फ्रूट. देर इज ए टाइम when the planter will come seeking for fruit. नहीं तो खेत में पेड़ लगाया हुआ व्यक्ति क्या करेगा, ढूंढते हुए आएगा. We should understand, we serve a God who is a seeker. हम ऐसे एक परमेश्वर की सेवा आराधना करते हैं जो हमें ढूंढने वाला परमेश्वर. Even the Bible says he went after seeking the lamb which was lost. Hello, हम ऐसे एक परमेश्वर की आराधना करते हैं जो कि ढूंढने वाला एक परमेश्वर है. He seeks and he finds. वो ढूंढता है और उसको पा भी लेता है. तो हमें मालूम करना चाहिए कि परमेश्वर ढूंढने वाले एक परमेश्वर है. We serve a God who always seeks. When God seeks you, are you available? जब परमेश्वर तुझे ढूंढते हैं, तू available है क्या? Are you there to render your part? तुम अपने हिस्सा दिखाने के लिए तुम तैयार हो क्या? मगर इस उदाहरण में हम लोग देख सकते हैं क्या हुआ, परमेश्वर क्या हुआ, ढूंढ कर आए मगर क्या नहीं मिला, फल नहीं मिला. वी सी हियर ही केम लुकिंग फॉर फ्रूट बट डिड नॉट फाइंड एनी. हेलो, जब परमेश्वर तुझे ढूंढ आते हैं, तुझ में कुछ दिखाई देने वाला हिस्सा है कि नहीं? When God is seeking you, is there anything that God can see? यहां पर देख सकते हैं फ्रूट, फल. A tree is identified by its fruit. एक पेड़ में फल ही कौन सा पेड़ समझाता है, नहीं तो बताता है. अगर फल नहीं है तो वो कौन सा पेड़ पता नहीं चलेगा, बहुत मुश्किल है. सो द फ्रूट रिप्रेजेंट्स द ट्री और गिव्स एन इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द ट्री. और फ्रूट इज समथिंग दैट ओरिजिनेट्स और कम्स फ्रॉम समथिंग एज एन एफेक्ट और रिजल्ट. फल एक ऐसी चीज है जो कि रिजल्ट प्रोसेस की एक दिखावा। हेलो, इट शुड बी फ्रूट। फ्रूट इज डिक्लेयरिंग द रिजल्ट। आर यू देयर? हमें मालूम करना चाहिए परमेश्वर ढूंढ के आने वाला एक परमेश्वर है। वी सर्व ए गॉड हु ऑलवेज सीक्स। ही सीक्स फॉर फ्रूट। व्हाट डज फ्रूट रिप्रेजेंट? इट रिप्रेजेंट्स आवर वर्क, आवर एक्शन, आवर डीड, आवर यूटिलिटी, आवर प्रॉफिट। हाउ वी आर एडवांटेजियस to the world. Hello. If you have something, it should be useful to others. अगर तुझमें कुछ है खासियत तो वो दूसरों को फायदेमंद होना जरूरी है। इसीलिए तो परमेश्वर पुराने नियम के व्यवस्थाओं में क्या किया, प्रथम फल, द फर्स्ट फ्रूट इन ओल्ड कवेनेंट। वी सी द फर्स्ट फ्रूट इज बीन गिवन टू गॉड। व्हाई? बिकॉज द फर्स्ट प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द फ्रूट विच कम्स आउट ऑफ द ट्री और आउट ऑफ द प्लांट और आउट ऑफ द सीड और आउट ऑफ द प्लांटेशन, It's been dedicated before the Lord as a praise offering, as a thank offering. नहीं तो जो फल पहली उगता है उसको क्या करते हैं, परमेश्वर के निकट अर्पण किया जाता है। क्यों? ताकि वो परमेश्वर से शुरुआत हुआ और परमेश्वर का ही है, उसका एक वर्णन दिखा रहा है। Why do we give first fruit to God? Because it's an implication to show respect towards God, saying God is the person who was working behind the background of the tree, supplying the complete nutrition, supplying the required vitamins, supplying the required water quantity, supplied the required sunlight, made the complete and best atmosphere for the plant to grow into maturity. After being grown, obviously the tree will produce its fruit. नहीं तो जो भी जरूरी हिस्सा है उन सब हिस्साओं को पेड़ को परमेश्वर ने ही दिया है। तो देने के कारण से पहली हिस्सा परमेश्वर को देख के बता रहे हैं कि वो पेड़ भी परमेश्वर का है, वो फल भी परमेश्वर का है, और उस जिसने उसको उगवाया, जिसने उसको यहां तक लेके आया है वो भी परमेश्वर है, और भविष्य में भी लेके जाने वाला व्यक्ति भी परमेश्वर है। When you give the first fruit to God, you indirectly reveal an information that the tree belongs to God, the fruit belongs to God. In future, if it is fruitful, it will be given to God. It will be utilized for your benefit. But it is of God. वो परमेश्वर का है, उस चीज को स्थिर करने के लिए बताया जा रहा है। Hello. We need to give. Why? By giving, we are glorifying God. देने के द्वारा हम परमेश्वर को क्या कर रहे हैं, महिमानित कर रहे हैं। If you don't give, you are insulting God. तुम परमेश्वर को क्या कर रहे हो, इंसल्ट कर रहे हो। उतना ही तुम बोल नहीं देकर तुम क्या बोल रहे हो कि हाँ ये ऐसे ही उगा, ऐसा ही फल हुआ, ऐसे हुआ। नो, वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड। हेलो, इसलिए यहां पे हम लोग देखें इस उदाहरण में, इन दिस पैराबल वी सॉ देयर इज अ पर्सन हु इज एक्सपेक्टिंग फॉर फ्रूट, देयर इज अ पर्सन हु इज रेडी टू सीक फॉर फ्रूट. At that moment, are you ready? ऐसी एक स्थिति में ढूंढ के आते वक्त तुम रेडी हो क्या? हेलो, what did happen? He found nothing. जब वो आके inquiry किया, when he had an examination, when he had an observation to the complete tree, he found nothing. We need to understand, church is a plantation and God has his rights to come and inquire us, to come and observe us, to come and examine us, to find out our practices and experiences. Hello, to see us, to discover us, to understand us how we are. Hello, जब हम परमेश्वर के खेत में उग रहे हैं, परमेश्वर को हक बनता है हमें ऑब्जर्व करने के लिए, हमें एग्जामिन करने के लिए, हमें परीक्षा करने के लिए, हमारे अंदर इंक्वायरी लेने के लिए. क्यों? ताकि हमारा हमारा प्रैक्टिस क्या है, हमारा सिद्धांत क्या है, हमारा एक्सपीरियंस कैसा चल रहा है. ही ऑब्जर्व्स द थिंग. हेलो, हम कैसे चीजों को समझ रहे हैं. Church belongs to God. People belongs to God. Everything in this world belongs to God. God has the right to examine us. God has the right to recognize, detect, discover us. Not only us, everything in this world. But as a Christian, as a child of God, we should reveal ourselves before God. हम अपने आप को क्या करना चाहिए, परमेश्वर के सामने प्रदर्शित करना जरूरी है. Why does it a tree bear fruit? क्यों एक पेड़ में फल होती है? कारण उस पेड़ में क्या हो रहा है, बढ़ोतरी हो रहा है, उसका एक एक सफलीकरण है फल देना. Why does a tree give fruit? Because when a tree is completely mature or growing as a total, as a substitute bonus, it gives fruit. So we need to understand, if a tree planted inside a vineyard and the planter expects for something to reveal the growth of the tree. नहीं तो एक पेड़ की बढ़ोतरी कितना है उस चीज को वर्णन करते हुए. But what happened in this particular passage? He did not find any fruit. मगर उसमें क्या कुछ भी फल दिखाई नहीं दिया. So what did he do? He said to the winekeeper, for 3 years have I come looking for fruit on this tree, but I have found nothing. Cut it down. Why does it even use up the ground? Hello? What happened? 3 years it received the best water, best resources, best nutrients, but it did not produce any fruit. There was found nothing in it. जब 3 सालों से उस पेड़ को लगाया गया है मगर उस पेड़ में क्या नहीं मिल रहा है, फल नहीं मिल रहा है, तो क्या कर रहे हैं? आखिरी में एक ही बात बोल रहे हैं, उस पेड़ को क्या कर दो, काट डालो, कट इट डाउन. व्हाई डज इट इवन यूज अप द ग्राउंड? उसको क्या करो, काट दो. हेलो, इफ देयर इज नो फ्रूट ऑब्वियसली देयर इज एक्स बीन रेडी. अगर फल पूर्णता नहीं है, फल नहीं है, तो सोच लो परमेश्वर क्या यूज करेंगे. पेड़ काटने के लिए औजार यूज करेंगे. हेलो, वहां पे एक चीज हमें बहुत अच्छी से देखना चाहिए, वो आखिरी में बता. द लास्ट वर्स इज लाइक दिस, व्हाई डज इट इवन यूज अप द ग्राउंड? हेलो, क्यों उस जमीन को भी ये पेड़ क्या कर रहा है, फायदे में ले रहा है? और else, if the plant does not bear fruit, the plant is completely using the soil. That's the first point. And the second point is that the tree grew into a huge mass. And what does it do? It's blocking the sunlight and not even allowing other plants to grow. Hello? अगर तेरी बढ़ोतरी तेरी अंदर फल पूर्णता नहीं लाता, तू जमीन को हड़प रहा है. एक दूसरी, तू इतना बड़ा और कामयाब बन गया है कि तू क्या कर रहा है, रोशनी को भी ब्लॉक कर रहा है, दूसरे पेड़ पौधों को नहीं दे रहा है. ग्रोथ इज गुड, डोंट ग्रो सच ए वे you only should use the complete soils, you only should use the complete water, you only should use the complete resources, you only should use the complete nutrients and don't even care for others. That's the thing happening inside the church. People are so blessed, so favored, so self-oriented, so selfish. They grow in their particular area, receiving all the best nutrients and all the best adaptations required. And what does it do? It does not even allow other trees to grow. And it is a way blocking the resources. And not even helping other trees, other plants. So what's the use? If there is a tree and it is grown up, and if it does not bear any, if it bears any fruit, then receiving the nutrients and receiving the complete water levels and receiving the complete sunlight, it's beneficial. Hello. So we need to understand, church is a plantation, church is a farm in which trees are being planted, Why did God plant the tree? He is expecting for fruit. Why did He plant you inside the garden? Why did He plant you inside a plantation? So that you can receive the best nutrients. You can receive the best resources. You can receive the best things. After receiving the best things, the tree should bear fruits. Showing the minimum courtesy of receiving the sunlight, the soil, the moisture, the nourishment. But if it does not give any fruit, whatever it receives, it is a hindrance to other trees. That's the reason the person who came to seek, the person who found no fruit, he even calculated the years. 3 years. 3 years of sunlight, 3 years of water, 3 years of fertilizers, 3 years of nutrients, 3 years of protection, 3 years of constant labor. But no fruit. What does 3 years represent? A man's life is being categorized into three categories. Number one, childhood. Number two, adulthood. Number three, old age. These are the three categories of a man's life. God gave you a best childhood. God gave you the best adulthood. God gave you the best old age. What did you do? Did you bear fruit? Did you have relationship with God? But what happened to this tree? It did not produce anything. Indirectly, the tree had such a growth that other trees were being disturbed. So this particular tree started growing in such a way, it started destroying or abolishing or making other trees idle, because they does not receive anything. This tree receives everything. So this particular tree is making other trees unemployed, inactive, and it does not even cooperate with others. What's the use? That's the reason the person who came to seek for fruit, he saw nothing. Indirectly, he sees the other trees have been disturbed. So what did he say? 3 years I examined this particular tree. 3 years I observed it completely. 3 years I worked on it. But what did it do? It's growing, but without fruit. Hello? Don't be a person inside the church making others unemployed, making others inactive, making others incooperative. God called you inside the church to be active with others, to be cooperative with others, to be employed with others. To share things equally. And after receiving all the favors and blessings, यू एक्ट सो स्मार्ट, यू एक्ट सो सेल्फिश, वट कैन गॉड डू? ही कैन ओनली यूज एक्ट्स. I really thank the Lord. In this particular passage, he did not curse the tree. Thank God. मैं परमेश्वर को धन्यवाद करता हूं. वो क्या नहीं किया, पेड़ को श्राप नहीं दिया. हेलो, डोंट बी सच ए पर्सन इनसाइड द चर्च डिप्लीटिंग अदर्स एफिशिएंसी. दूसरों की कामयाबी को दबा के रखने वाले मत बनो. डोंट बी ए पर्सन विथ डिप्रेविटी ऑफ फोर्स. डोंट यूज योर इन्फ्लुएंस एंड पावर फॉर योर सेल्फ. डोंट कॉज अदर्स टू सीज. Don't put an end to others' activity. Don't be a hindrance. If you are doing that, you are being fruitless. And even you are making others fruitless. The way you are receiving everything, the other plants are too receiving the same. But you developed into such a greater extent that even the resources which the other should other tree should get, that is being trapped, that is being blocked, or that is being used by yourself. That's the situation happening right now inside the church. People are blessed, but what's the use? People are favored, but what's the use? Hello, you are inside a plantation. And you should understand, the complete plantation should receive the best. Don't be a person hindering others' activity. Don't separate others. Don't discharge others' resources. Don't terminate others' growth. If you do so, don't worry. There is a God who is ready with his axe. The moment he gives the order, he can chop it off. No. But what happened? The vineyard replied to him, "Leave it alone, sir. One more year, I will dig around it, put in fertilizers." Hello, that's the grace of Jesus Christ. Even when you were blessed and favored, even when you grew to a greater extent, but lack of fruit, the grace of Jesus Christ is even upon you. Why? Letting you one more chance, giving you one more year to be productive. For that, what did Jesus do? He dug around it. He put fertilizers. Hello. Why did he dug? Why did he dig? Because there was such activities happening inside. He just wanted to block it. When you dig something, you don't know what is beneath. जब तुम खोदते हो, तुम्हें पता नहीं कि नीचे क्या है. सो व्हेन देर इज अ डिगिंग व्हाट हैपेंस देर इज समथिंग हर्टिंग द रूट्स हेलो देर इज सम पेनिट्रेशंस व्हाई सो दैट देर कैन बी फर्टिलाइजर्स एडेड टू दैट पर्टिकुलर एरियाज एंड इट विल allow you to be alone for some more time to heal yourself. Hello, what did Jesus do? He gave his love. He gave you his grace. He left you alone for some more time. He gave you a chance. He gave you everything to bear, to produce, to fashion, to form. Hello? Why did Jesus come into this world? He came into this world so that you can be a fruit. You are receiving the best fertilizer. That's the word of God. You are receiving the best Holy Ghost. You received the complete blood of Jesus. Why? So that there can be a connection with you and Jesus. Hello. That's the reason the Bible says, by his stripes we are healed. So this tree got hurt inside the root. So the word of God or the fertilizers, Holy Ghost, the blood of Jesus completely wrapped the complete area where it was hot and it started receiving all the best things. Hello. इसलिए हमें मालूम करना चाहिए, एक साल भी उस पेड़ को दिया गया ताकि उस पेड़ में क्या मिल सके, फल पूर्णता. अगर हम लोग होसैया की किताब उसकी नवा अध्याय उसकी 10वीं वचन अगर पढ़ते, इफ यू टर्न अवर बाइबल्स टू होसैया चैप्टर 9:10, होसैया की किताब नवा अध्याय उसका 10वां वचन ऐसा कहता है, आई फाउंड इज़राइल लाइक ग्रेप्स इन द वर्ल्डनेस, आई सॉ योर फादर्स as a first ripe fruit on the fig tree in its first season, but they came to Balpor and consecrated themselves to shameful worship of Baal and became, because of their spiritual and physical adultery, they became a detestable and loathsome as the thing they loved. What happened to the people of Israel? God found Israel like a grapes in the wilderness. God took them out from Egypt and made them to walk through the wilderness so that they can produce the best grapes. They can be a refreshing delight to God. They can represent the God. They can reveal the greatness of God. So what did the ancestors of Israel do? They were as the first ripe fruit on the fig tree in its season. That's the thing God saw in the ancestor. Who were the ancestor? Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph, till Moses. There were some ancestors who produced some fruit. God saw it. They produced the fruit in the right season. But what happened? When they came to a place called Baal, what did they do? How God brought them. And what did they start to do? They started to worship other gods. They forgot God. They forgot the true living God. And started adapting false God. Worshipping the Baal. Hello. Such a shameful activity. After receiving all the first blessings, law, worship, praise, honor, they were so full enough. What did they do? They adapted themselves to develop intimacy with false God. False worship, false law, false attitude, being rebellious. And what did they do? And because of their spiritual and physical adultery, physical and spiritual adultery. What does adultery mean? Having relationship with a woman who is not your wife. Or else, if you are a married person, you're married, and you should have relationship and intimacy with your wife. But without having intimacy and relationship with your wife, having relationship and intimacy with some other woman indicates you are committing adultery. So what did Israelites do? They were the grapes, best grapes. They were the best fig trees, fig fruits. But they started to backslide from God. They started living the intimacy with God and started adapting false God in such a way, even their physical and spiritual life completely got split out. Hello? What did they do? They established false pagan worship. This particular incident is been taken from the book of Numbers, when Balaam, who was given money to curse the people of Israelites, he gave a simple trick. What did he do? He just polluted the Israelites. Removed the holiness from the people. He just gave a simple idea. What did he do? He just gave a suggestion to the king, Balak, saying, just send some good-looking girls of Moab. Just let them walk through the camps or nearby houses or nearby areas. So what did they do? These girls beautified themselves और दे पुट ऑन होल मेकअप, दे डेकोरेटेड देमसेल्फ विथ फॉल्स ब्यूटी एंड दे स्टार्टेड ट्रैपिंग द पीपल ऑफ इसराइलाइट्स. बाय डूइंग दैट दे लेफ्ट देयर फैमिली, दे लेफ्ट देयर वाइफ, दे लेफ्ट देयर इंटीमसी विद गॉड एंड स्टार्टेड एडेप्टिंग फॉल्स एटीट्यूड. दे बिगैन टू एक्ट लाइक पेगन्स. They rejected the law, they rejected the worship, they rejected the fellowship with God, they rejected the intimacy with God and started doing things which was against the word of God. Or they adapted things which is pagan, anti-God or false God, false worship, false attitude. Which itself brought a barrier between Israel and God. They took sin like a pig to filth, just rolling in the mud. Why? To have friendship with new people. No. If you remain in God, you will produce your fruit. But what did these people do? They left the intimacy with God and adapted false friends. And they thought, these false friends can help us to bear fruit. These pagan religious people will help us to be religious. These pagan worshippers will help us to receives the blessing of God. But what did it happen? They were into the filth, shameless. Hello. If you have intimacy with God, you cannot have intimacy with pagans. If you are intimate with God, you cannot have intimacy with a person who does not have God. There is a saying in English, show me your friend, then I can say who you are. If you show me your friend, I can say what kind of person you are. Israelites had friendship with God and they had their best time. But when they started adapting new friends, that's the thing people do. Sometimes people, they leave their old friends and start hanging with new friends. Why? Newer friends have new technologies, new ideas, new influences, new activities. That's the thing the Israelites did. Previously, I was speaking about an example from the garden or a plantation or a vineyard in which there was a plant. What did that plant do? It received all best nutrients and even it blocked the other trees. Right now happening inside the church. People are so busy to adapt to the pagan activities, pagan thinking. By doing that, दे आर पोल्यूटिंग द होली सेक्ट. डज द थिंग द इजराइलाइट्स डिड. What was the trick used to pollute this people? The trick was that a man of God came to curse the people, but he just initiated a wrong suggestion. What was the wrong suggestion? He just told the king, who? Balak. Told him, just send your best girls, just beautify them, just send them, just leave them alone, they will do whatever they can. Hello. By doing this, the complete Israelites polluted themselves. They involved into sin. They physically and spiritually acted in adultery. Hello. We need to understand. We are separate. The church is always separate. The church is always separate. We cannot adapt the outer world inside the church. The church should influence the outer world. The world should not influence the church. The outer world should not influence the church. The church should influence the outer world. Right now, the churches are adapting the pagan activities inside the church. What pagans do, that we do. And we say, it's for the glory of God. No, it's not bearing fruit. No. Pagans can do anything. Whatever they like, they can do it. But inside the church, if we are a member in God's family, we have some restriction, we have some limitations, we are bound with the law. We are wrapped inside grace. The blood of Jesus covers us. We cannot come out. The Holy Spirit guides us. The word of God equips us. We are limited in that particular area. Why did God keep you there? So that we, being spiritually blessed, physically blessed, physically fruitful, spiritually fruitful, equipping ourselves so that we can be ready to get out the world and we can influence others. If we are fruitful, we can make others to eat our fruits. If we are completely equipped, we can make others to equip. But what does we see in this particular generation? The church is influenced by the pagan activities. Whatever the pagans do, the church just receives it to glorify God. You should know, it does not represent God. It does not glorify God. By doing this, you are losing the quality of being fruitful. You are indirectly giving a chance to God to use the axe. Hello. What what do the pagans do? What's the main criteria of the pagans? Their main influence is self-satisfaction, self-gratification, or self-pleasing. But what is the implication or importance of a church? They are called, they are brought giving price. Why? So they can be God dependent. Hello, right now, think about yourself, how you are, how fruitful you are. Are you inside the church and being fruitless? You should know there is a God who is ready to seek, who is ready to check you completely. He is expecting some fruits. Don't insult his activities. Don't pollute his holiness. Don't act unspiritual. Turn back to God. It's time to surrender before God. Let's surrender ourselves. Let's open our heart and say to God, Holy God, just help me. Holy Spirit, just remind me where I need to be fruitful. Just help me, Lord. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, in this particular morning, we come to your presence, Lord. We were discussing regarding the church. Lord, the church is running fruitless. Help the church to be fruitful, Lord. Help the church members to be fruitful, Lord. The planter is expecting for fruits, Lord. Let our fruits be useful to the world, to the community outside. Let the pagans understand what great fruit we have. We serve a God who is the starter and the finisher of our faith, the author of our grace. He is the person who is working behind us, rendering us all his grace and mercy, all his love and favor, so that we can be fruitful in life. Help us, Lord, to be fruitful. Don't allow the axe to be used on us, Lord. Help us, Lord. Give us one more chance. Give us one more year, Lord. We will be fruitful. Fertilize us, Lord. Dig us, Lord. Equip us, Lord. Thank you for all your grace and favor, Lord. We ask everything in the name of Jesus. And all the God's people said, Amen, Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.